first opened in 2002. There's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, the Motor City. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Houston Texans and the Detroit. Calendar has turned to December and we're in the home stretch now as we're underway in week 13. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Him a couple up to the 27.
Darius Geis, the ball carrier.
Nice job there by the
he was tackled at the 27-yard line.
A gain of two
brings up second and eight.
Because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Maiden's pass. Complete to Darius Geis.
And that's when it's fun to play.
No gain on the play. Brings up third down.
Get guys to the football and still the play. That's when you have a lot of fun playing on that side of the ball.
An early tough test on the opening drive. This is third and eight.
You don't want none, get them!
Third down defensively, they were just hoping to make a play and get off the field, get their offense on. Instead, they did one better. Pick it off, take it into the end zone.
Well, they did what you said. They got off the field.
They're going to have to come right back on.
The kicker on for the point after.
Right? They put the ball in the end zone. That's the way to start the game. That's the way to start the time.
It's up, it's good.
His kick is good. Makes the score Lions 7. Texans nothing.
It's following that kick 6. And now the kick is away. And that one will bounce.
The Texans take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive.
Darius Geis, the ball carrier.
Well, that's a real nice job.
He was tackled at the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup. It's second and eight.
We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times, you just don't take any step. Just get your feet forward.
Darius Geis, the ball carrier. He was brought down at the 28-yard line. It's a gain of a yard. And it's third down.
He just made a great play there.
He gets us away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And this punt will go out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
Shaq. 19, Tiger. 19, Tiger.
Let's go, dude.
79, Bronco. Check smash. Check smash.
First and 10 at the 34-yard line.
Looking to throw. Jacobs. Complete to Cook. It's across midfield and inside.
Dalvin Cook. That's good for a Lion.
I'm not sure if this play was designed for
First and 10 at the 43-yard line.
He got the ball to him. So second catch on the drive. He may not be a primary guy, but they definitely want him involved, don't they?
Absolutely. This early in the opening drive, as you said, two catches. So if they can get him going in the passing game, it should open up his running game, too.
He's going to launch this thing way downfield. Almost able to intercept
it. Jacobs the pass. Intended for DeAndre Swift. Incomplete.
Instead, second down.
It's now second and 10.
Second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Throwing again, Jacobs. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back.
The quarterback taken down and sacked by Ross Blacklock.
It'll go as a loss of
an 8-yard loss on the play. It's now third down.
Strike, they'll look to throw.
They'll take over first and 10 at the 40-yard line.
The road early, they got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gonna let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
Tackle, Rocco 80.
Tackles, tackle. Blocks 59. Blocks 59.
Off play action. And under the Lions pressure.
The quarterback sacked. A loss of 6 yards. It's second down.
We got three. Shit.
Hit the street. Guys. Get this down.
Darius Geis, the ball carrier. He was tackled at the 46-yard line. It's a gain of a yard. And it's third down.
You're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they haven't thrown it all the time. But you still have to be alone for the draw. And make sure you don't get hurt.
Ready to kick off their next drive. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often with the interception?
I think it does depend on
the rifles now. It's intercepted. Picked up by Justin Reed.
Jacobs pass. Intercepted by the Texans. They'll take over first and 10 at the 30-yard line.
Make the proper throws. I've seen guys in this league throw 4 interceptions in a game and win. He's got to understand. Put it behind you. Keep pressing forward.
So first and 10 now from the 30.
Darius Geis, the ball carrier.
Brandon, 5 yards.
Patrick Queen on the tackle.
Let's get back to the huddle and make
it's a gain of five. Brings up second and five at the Lions' 26-yard line.
Pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five.
Incomplete.
He's missed out his first four passing attempts. The rhythm is just not there to begin this ball game.
5 yards to go.
Position to begin the drive, and now they look up at a third and five. Off the play throw. Hayden. In a heavy traffic, and it's intercepted.
The third down pass.
And a big turn.
Intercepted.
These guys will get the football.
The Lions take over first and 10. At their own 6-yard line.
Meeting room, but they better keep it rolling. Three picks last week, two here now in the first quarter.
Everyone talks about creating turnovers and getting takeaways, but until it gets put into action,
first and 10 at the 24-yard line.
And utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backside of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got him by oh, he just got a nice first down.
What he's on the side, he puts backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. And that will be
Jacob's pass. Incomplete on the deep ball. Brings up second and 10 at the 24-yard line.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10.
Check four, check four. Out, 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 out.
To throw again, Jacobs. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10.
Take over first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And two picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects it.
We'll see where his confidence is because the great ones.
Down. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Operating from the gun. And for the third time here, this half, it's intercepted.
up a first down and goal at the 6 yard line.
Do not adjust your set. This is not instant replay. This is a defense that is locked in. They're essentially running the routes for the receivers and turning into the receivers themselves, aren't they? I mean, it is amazing what I'm seeing because the reaction to the
Jacob's pass leads to number 84. No gain on the play. Leads to second and goal at the Texans' 6 yard line.
But that window closed quickly.
18 Cardinal, 18 Cardinal. What quiz? Seven Pirates.
Looking to throw on second down. Jacobs. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
Jacob's pass intended for Evan Engram. Incomplete. It's now third and goal.
They don't exist when you're this close to the goal line, but as a former DB, I liked it closer to the goal line. Tighter windows made it easier to cover people.
Dalvin Cook on the carry.
And now fourth and goal.
Tremaine Edmonds on the tackle.
This defense can hold him to a field goal.
No gain on the play. Brings up fourth and goal.
But psychologically take over the ball game. This started with first and goal. So they were in four down territory right from the beginning. I say you finish it off and go for the touchdown.
And he takes this one again.
Kicker on for the point after. The kick is good. Makes the score Lions 20, Texans nothing.
Oftentimes when you start counting receivers, that's exactly what you do. You start from the widest receiver, work your way inside. Who gets lost sometimes? The back in the backfield. That's exactly what happened there.
He got into the end zone. Decision to bring it out, not a
Jalen Reagor on the return. The Texans take over first and 10 at their own 15-yard line.
20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these team special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10.
Darius Geis, the ball carrier. The tackle made by Gander Lawrence.
Officially nothing on
no gain on the play. Brings up second and 10 at the 15-yard line.
Looking to throw. Tatum. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds.
Hayden's pass intended for Jalen Reagor. Incomplete.
Third down.
It's third down.
Not good. 0-4 thus far. This is third and 10.
Go.
Absolutely, they're looking up at that top spot. Looking down at the second spot pretty soon. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward
the
side.
The Lions take over first and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
41, Mike. 470 Rangers, 70 Rangers.
Throwing to start the drive. He's going to be sad.
The quarterback sack by Derek Barnett. A big loss on the play. Brings up second down.
It'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. They take a shot downfield there.
Jacob's pass intended for Evan Engram. Incomplete. It's now third down and long.
Jacobs, eluding pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep.
because here we are in December, right? It's season giving. Maybe for his own sake, after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity.
Complete to Darius Geis.
No gain, and it's
he's out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage.
Usually, the offense has an answer to anything a defense throws at them, including a safety valve, and that's what they did on that play. They went there, but the defense still made an excellent play. Welcome to no gain.
It's sad they pay me. I do this for free.
Second down pass. Intercepted. The Lions take over first and 10 at the 33-yard line.
And they're the ones that are doing all the leading, aren't they? Right? The three interceptions last week, that led to a victory. Three interceptions so far in this game, that has them out in front. We often think of the offense driving things. In this case, it's the defense, not just holding teams, but creating big plays for themselves.
Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah!
They'll take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Back in the good old days, probably back before you were born, if your starter threw four in the first half, he might throw eight or more for the game because they weren't going to pull him out. But nowadays, the patience level isn't right there. He's going to have to make some real adjustments, or the backup may see some time.
And it takes this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. I hate to say it, Charles, but the way that he has played in this first half, you just kind of hold your breath every time he drops back to pass.
Yeah, you might be holding your breath, but those guys on the defensive side of the ball, they've got big smiles on their faces. He's handing out picks like the people just leave the candy out at Halloween, and you take what you want. They're having a blast out there playing against him today.
Under the Lions' pressure, he's
quarterback is sacked.
He's closing
a loss of 14 on the play.
On the year.
It's third
and
down.
The 2 minute mark in this first half of action. Join Jonathan Coachman of the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the games going on here around the NFL. Deep ball for Goodwin.
Hayden's pass, complete to number 88, a pickup on the play of 54 yards. First down, Texans.
He's not shy, going downfield again there.
And you can't be, because if you back off after throwing an interception, your whole game plan just goes right out the window, and it makes things easier for a defense. And you and I both know, there's no quarterback in this league that's any good that doesn't throw an interception occasionally, and they usually bounce back in a big way. I've seen guys throw five and still find a way to win the game in the end.
Now a play fake here on first down. He gets it in the hands of Geis.
Hayden's pass, complete to Darius Geis.
A
6-yard pickup brings up second and 4 at the 29-yard line.
Hits his guy out in the flat.
Now, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you either throw on the touchdown or you throw on the check down. Earlier in the game, it was touchdown, interception. Now he got to the check down, a nice safe throw.
Hayden's pass. Complete to Will Fuller. A 3-yard gain on the play. Brings up third down.
And the Lions going with an extra DB here on third down. From the gun. Hayden going for it all. Detroit is up for the challenge.
Strike.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stop
the result of the play is a turnover on down.
50 here on fourth, and the Lions will take over. A little under 30 seconds to go. We'll see how they play it here on first and 10. Shake off the interception. He'll look to
throw. He gets this one into the hands of Dalvin Cook.
Oh, it's a big one now.
Second quarter, he's already
first and 10 at the 40-yard line.
It is a 100, the magic number for a really good game for a receiver. So he got a chance to really shatter and have a profound effect on this game.
Now he'll let it go deep.
And then Israel. That's good for a Lion.
They'll get him with 10 seconds to go. Halftime.
First and 10 at the 12-yard line.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Back to throw. Jenkins. And this is going to be intercepted.
Jenkins anticipation. Intercepted by the Texans.
It is banged.
They'll take over first and 10. At their own 20-yard line.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it. Didn't get it. That's a change in mentality.
I don't think it changes much for the head coach.
Changes pass intended for Mark Andrews. Incomplete.
Touchdowns, not field goals.
Brings up second and 10 at the 20-yard line.
Okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit.
We'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. And my goodness, another interception. Picked by Kevin Byard.
Pick up that ball.
Time is now one out on this first half of action.
That's the end of the first half with the score Lions 20, Texans nothing.
Down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Eddie Pinheiro set to kick off.
The Lions in the lead and they're going to get the football first as well as the second half is underway. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here. At the 25. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad not to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about that. We can shot a point on this spot. What are you thinking you got?
DeAndre Swift. That's good for a Lions.
Will they make up for it?
First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in for second blowout material.
Jacob's pass, incomplete on the throwaway.
That was good coverage along
it leads to second and 10.
For that one to get in there, it sails incomplete.
Check 41. 60 Bobcat. 60 Bobcat.
Hey, 41 Mike. 41.
Hey.
What's the ball? What's the ball?
41 Mike. 41 Mike. It's going to be a long day.
Back to the air on second down. Jacob's. Complete to Swift out of the backfield.
Jacob's
and
pass.
The play goes
complete
nowhere.
To DeAndre
down,
Swift.
Yardage at the 50
a loss
right
of one.
Midfield.
Brings up third down and 11.
And this now third and 11 after that second down completion actually went back a yard.
19 Lion.
I don't even know why this team showed up.
You go tight.
Operating from the gun. Jacob's. Going for the deep ball.
Jacob's pass incomplete on the deep ball. It's now fourth down.
Been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against it, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
You can't block me. You can't block me.
19. Riggs. Riggs.
Hey.
Mike 41. You've got to wedge that up.
Quit talking about it and bring it.
Go.
Jacob's.
Jacob's. complete.
Fourth down attempt earlier with
turnover unknown.
That fires for turnover on downs.
I like their aggressiveness. I like what they're doing. They got it the first time they went for it.
Hayden's pass complete to Darius Geis.
14 on that one.
A gain of 14.
First down,
Houston.
Taken about 7 yards deep.
The Texans take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And last time they shot out here, they lost the
Darius Geis, the ball carrier, taken down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. Second and 10 at the 25-yard line.
Pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. They stay on the ground.
Darius Geis, the ball carrier,
9 yards,
brought down at the 35-yard line. It's a gain of 9. Makes it third and inches.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback.
Hayden's pass, complete to number 28. He steps out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage.
Because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it,
but drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the
ball. Jordan Berry in punt formation.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
The Lions take over first and 10 at the 33-yard line.
And the Lions will get the football back in terrific field position. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
Hawk 70, Dragon 60, check 13.
First and 10 at the 23-yard line. The ball carried by the wide receiver. Out of bounds at the 19-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup. Second and 6.
Right down this group.
The kicker on for the point after.
The
kick is good.
Here in the third quarter.
Makes the score Lions 34, Texans nothing.
Team on the field now as they will send this one away. Taken in the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards.
Jalen Reagor on the return. The Texans take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. They have been struggling. I would imagine at the time they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now
that's the end of the third quarter of play with the score Lions 34, Texans nothing.
I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. Off the play fake.
Hayden's pass, intended for Mark Andrews, incomplete. He was covered by Patrick Queen.
This team,
Darius Geis, the ball carrier. Tackle made at the 38-yard line. A gain of 9 yards. And the Texans first down.
Usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, I'm thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see. see consistently.
Cable's pass complete to Will Fuller. A gain of 15.
The Texans pick up the
first down, Texans.
Remember, they tried to give him the ball and let him run on the last play, but I think the light bulb went off in their play caller's mind, and this time, he gets a little more directional. He's much more successful as well.
The throw here to Andrews, the tight end. And he goes down, but not before getting this
pass
inside the 25.
Complete to Mark Andrews.
A good pick up there.
A gain of 22 yards.
So this game was
first down, Houston.
And that completion there is going to artificially inflate the passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Cable's pass complete to Darius Geis. A 3-yard pickup brings up second and seven at the 21-yard line.
59, Mike, 59, Mike, check, check, 59. Bandit, bandit.
And all the way down inside the five.
Cable's pass. Complete to Will Fuller.
Going to use the second of their
first
timeouts.
And goal at
that's
the 4-yard line.
Just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line.
Darius Geis, the ball carrier.
No gain on the play that time.
Brought down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. Leads to second and goal at the Lions' 3-yard line.
But right now, if you're on the other side of the ball, you can imagine. Moving the football, gotta be that
Geis,
way.
Again, the ball carrier. Brought down just shy of the goal line.
They stay aggressive because you know they want to pitch this shutout.
Yeah, they have to be aggressive, but they also have to be smart about it as well because
Darius Geis, the ball carrier. Stopped short of the goal line. No gain on the play. Yes, fourth and goal at the 1-yard line. Darius Geis, the ball carrier. He was taken down behind the line of scrimmage. Result of the play is a turnover on down.
Because you teed it up really well. Finally get to the red zone. So there's got to be a little bit of frustration because they haven't moved the ball as well as they wanted to all game.
That's good for a Lion. First and 10 at the 30-yard line.
It began way back inside the five. So first and 10 now from the 30.
Cook, the ball carrier. He's brought down at the 39-yard line. It's a gain of 9. Brings up second and a yard.
Again, it's Cook. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line.
Dalvin Cook. That's good for a Lion. First and 10 at the 43-yard line. Receiver, the ball carrier.
Officially no gain.
Taken down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10 at the 43-yard line.
Jacobs. Now he'll let it go deep over the middle. And now here's another interception. Picked up by Justin Lee.
They'll take over first and 10 at the 40-yard line.
But just think of how it is for his teammates, because after the first few, you know they're going over to him, hey, we'll get him next time. Now they're probably a little bit frustrated. And if you're a receiver, you're thinking to yourself, any ball that's in the air, you become receiver and defensive back. You got to go deep for the ball so you don't get another one picked off.
Now the throw.
Hayden's pass.
Come on, guys,
complete to Will Fuller.
That'll be
a gain of 27 on the play. And the Texans first down.
First and 10.
All day, baby. Let's go. Let's go.
So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And my goodness, another interception.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 31-yard line.
12 guys on the field. It feels like there's an extra on every snap because they have really struggled to make headway through the air.
Here's Cook. It's a big one. Just a yard on the first down carry. Second and 9.
Zach Cunningham on the tackle. 1 yard gain brings up second and 9 at the 32-yard line.
Instead of trying to bounce it out and turn it into a big play, which might have turned into a big loss, God just took his hands and took 1 yard.
Yeah, he's able to get most of what he needed.
DeAndre Swift, ball carrier.
And it's 3rd and 2.
Keanu Neal brought him down. That's a gain of 7. Makes it 3rd and 2.
The
ball carried by the wide receiver. Intended for number 84. Incomplete. A loss of 2 yards. It's 4th down.
It's a little too close to the goal line.
The Texans take over first and 10
for a touchback
at their own 20-yard line.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to the victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case.
Don't worry about it, baby. I ain't worried about it. Let's go.
Hayden's pass complete to Jalen Rager. Touchdown, Houston.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man. So they will get on the scoreboard here. Give them credit for that. Too little, too late, but no 0. Are you, you're going slow clap on me.
Not very nice, is it?
No, but...
Eddie Pinheiro lining up for the extra point.
And the lead drops from 34 to
27. The kick is good. Makes the score Lions 34, Texans 7. Eddie Pinheiro set to kick off.
After the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off.
I'm gonna show you, man. It don't even matter, baby. It don't matter. It's okay.
Touchdown, Houston.
That's what I want right there. That's what I want.
Special teams, and it results in the scoop and the score.
They talk all the time on special teams about keeping your head on a swivel, trying to see the whole field. Hard
Eddie
to do
Pinheiro
when things are going
lining
that
up
fast.
For the
Bodies
extra point.
All over the place. You're just trying to find the right guy.
The kick is good. Makes the score Lions 34, Texans 14.
So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. An incredibly short score fielded way out there. Now a crease here as he's past the 30.
I'm only going to be able to carry it so far.
All right, all right.
Today's final score, Lions 34, Texans 14.
I'll tell you what, I can't remember a defensive performance as good as this one. They seemingly forced turnover after turnover after turnover every time you turned around.